Hello everyone and welcome to the Centennial of the Pulitzer Prizes. My name is Paul Salopek and I'm a National Geographic Fellow and a foreign correspondent. I'm honored to join you today, even virtually, from the western shores of the Caspian Sea in Central Asia, my latest overseas posting. I walked here from Ethiopia. It's taken me more than 3 years. I probably wouldn't be able to point out that bizarre factoid if it weren't for the Pulitzer Prizes. I won both of my Pulitzers at the Chicago Tribune. The first was for a series of articles on the questionable ethics of a pioneering human genetics program. Scientists from technologically privileged countries had banded together to launch a survey of the human family tree across the world, a sort of global genealogy test that would use DNA of diverse ethnic groups to answer some big questions about human identity and relatedness, and also open up new vistas for genetic medicine. Unfortunately, those ideals were undermined by accusations that minority groups were not informed about the end uses of their donated DNA. After my articles ran, the project quietly folded, and since then, much tougher ethical protocols have been adopted for genetic research. My second award came from work in Africa, where I'd been based for many years. I'd covered the Congo Civil War by paddling down the Congo River in a dugout canoe. I reported on the AIDS epidemic, and I covered the terrible Angolan Civil War as a sort of hostile corporate takeover, which it pretty much was, pitting a corrupt, oil-stoked central government against a blood diamond-funded rebellion. Pulitzer Prizes are not a destination, though. They're milestones and a longer journey. And I think that many of us who are fortunate enough to be recognized by the Pulitzer Committee hope to leverage this honor into helping us arrive at our best work. I suppose that's what I'm trying to do today, working with my media partners at National Geographic. But I probably can't recommend my rather slow and roundabout career path to too many other folks. Take a look. Everybody has a story. They may tell it in a different language, they may whisper it, they may shout it, but they have a story.
My name is Paul Salopek, and I'm a journalist and National Geographic Fellow.
I'm interested in telling the untold stories of people who live around the world, who work in farms, in factories, people who make societies work.
The way I see it is that we're all walking together.
My Out of Eden Walk project involves not just walking across continents, but through the major stories of our day. I want to slow my readers down and use the walk as a global laboratory for more immersive, more interconnected, and hopefully more meaningful digital journalism. I'm following the ancient footsteps of the first human diaspora out of Africa, compiling multimedia stories as I go. Since leaving Ethiopia in 2013, I've written about things like the startling effect of Somali piracy on climate research, where violence at sea has created a huge meteorological data-gathering hole in the Indian Ocean, making it harder to predict the weather patterns in southern Asia, a breadbasket of the world. I've covered the unprecedented tides of war refugees in the Middle East from a unique inside view, as it were, often walking from tent to tent across the region, gaining boot-level insights into a tragedy so profound that it will be haunting our grandchildren. And in Turkey and in the Caucasus, I trekked through and wrote about one of the oldest political disputes in today's international stage, the standoff between Turkey and Armenia over the genocide of Armenians in 1915, a dispute that locks both parties into underdevelopment, isolation, and poverty. But just as important, I'm also getting young readers to both consume global news and value its worth through the art of storytelling. I think that more than ever, this is becoming a critical part of our job today, and I'm lucky to have two great education partners who are helping me do this. The Pulitzer Center on Crisis Reporting is using the walk's journalism to build smart curriculums for schools and universities across the United States. In one innovation, the center is partnering with the Boy Scouts to use the walk's journalism to get youngsters to report and reflect on their immediate surroundings. At the Philmont Scout Ranch in New Mexico, some 22,000 scouts and leaders a year are writing about their experiences and how they fit into the global panorama of events. This year, an essay contest winner will be joining the walk for a couple days in Uzbekistan. And at the New York City Lab School, an entire senior class is spending the spring studying the walk and preparing for walks of their own around their neighborhood, inspired by the various themes of my project, as well as by visits from other center grantees who reported on issues like food security, public health, and the plight of underpaid workers. The walk's cartographer, Jeff Blossom at Harvard, will be teaching the kids how to map their own walks digitally using GPS technology. Another of my education partners, Project Zero at Harvard, meanwhile, has created a digital platform for thousands of school kids in more than 40 different countries around the world. Two lunches at the Lowe Library at Columbia University helped make all of this happen. So, from my nomadic newsroom, which today happens to be in Aktau, Kazakhstan, I send you all my sincere greetings, and I congratulate the Pulitzer Prizes on reaching 100, and the Pulitzer Center on reaching 10. Okay, onward to China, about a 2 years walk east of here.